In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of ligaments around shoulder girdle. Today's ligaments are very important for shoulder movement. I will explain why. But let me explain ligaments around sternum and clavicle. First ligament is this one. This ligament connects clavicle and sternum. That is why this is sternoclavicular ligament. Sternoclavicular. Literally, this connects sternum and clavicle. Easy, right? Next one is this one. This ligament is between right clavicle and left clavicle. This ligament is in between clavicles. This is interclavicular ligament. Interclavicular ligament. Easy, right? The last one from this picture is this one. This connects first rib and clavicle. This is costoclavicular ligament. Costoclavicular ligament. Costo means rib. So that is why this ligament connects ribcage and clavicle. Costoclavicular ligament. Why am I explaining these ligaments? Because they are not that famous compared to knee ligaments, ankle ligaments, or shoulder ligaments, right? But if you have injury in these ligaments, that can affect shoulder movement. Why? Because this is closer view of shoulder. This is clavicle. Imagine these ligaments are on medial part. Imagine there's ligaments. And clavicle is here. And these are part of scapula. Imagine if these ligaments get damaged. You can't move your clavicle, right? Then if your clavicle doesn't move, your scapula doesn't move because they are all connected. If your clavicle doesn't move, your scapula doesn't move. If your scapula doesn't move, your shoulder doesn't move. That is why connective tissue around sternum and clavicle are so important for shoulder joint, even though they are very far away. Does it make sense? That is why I include these ligaments for today's video. Let's move on to ligaments around scapula. Again, this is closer view. I will explain ligaments around scapula, particularly on anterior part. First one is this one. This is conoid ligament. Conoid ligament. Next to conoid ligament, there's also ligament. This one is trapezoid ligament. Trapezoid ligament. And these two ligaments together, it is coracoclavicular ligament. Coracoclavicular ligament, because these guys connect coracoid process and clavicle. Simple enough, right? Next one is this one. This is very long name. This is superior transverse scapular ligament. Superior transverse scapular ligament. By the way, what is function of ligament? Main function is to stabilize joint, right? But this ligament connects part of scapula and part of scapula. So this ligament doesn't have to stabilize joint. How come there is ligament? Okay. Do you see this notch? There's notch on scapula. In this notch, one nerve penetrates. Okay, one nerve penetrates this notch. This is the suprascapular nerve. If there is no ligament above nerve, maybe there is chance that this nerve pops out from this notch. It's gonna be problem. That is why such a connective tissue exists, to keep nervous tissue in adequate position. Okay, anyway, this is superior transverse scapular ligament. Let's go to next one. Next one is this one. This connects coracoid process and acromion. This is coracoacromial ligament. Coracoacromial ligament. By the way, these ligaments also connect scapula and scapula. How come there's ligament? Okay, same thing like superior transverse scapular ligament. There is muscle beneath this ligament that is supraspinatus. If this ligament doesn't exist, maybe there's chance that supraspinatus pops out from scapula. It's gonna be a problem. Then, that is why this ligament exists. Human body is very concise and very precise, right? Next one, this one. This connects clavicle and acromion. Thus, this is acromioclavicular ligament. Acromioclavicular. Now, last one from this picture. So, let me erase the supraspinatus a little bit. That's it. Last one from this picture is this one. This ligament connects coracoid process and humerus. This is coracohumeral ligament. Coracohumeral ligament. Interestingly, if this ligament gets tight, that inhibits internal rotation of shoulder. It's a little bit weird. This is on superior part and anterior part of shoulder, but this dysfunction creates internal rotation dysfunction. That's very weird. That sounds very weird, but that's how it is. This is a very interesting thing, right? Anyway, I explained ligaments around scapula in this picture. So next picture, I'm going to explain ligaments around shoulder joint. Okay, I'm going to explain three famous ligaments plus one interesting ligament. There are three ligaments on anterior part of shoulder. That is glenohumeral ligament. Glenohumeral ligament. Gleno means scapula. Humeral means humerus. That makes sense. This part is superior glenohumeral ligament. This part is middle glenohumeral ligament. And the last one is inferior glenohumeral ligament. That's very simple, right? The last one is quite unique. This ligament is not very well-known ligament. That runs like this. This runs like spiral direction. That is why this is spiral glenohumeral ligament. Spiral glenohumeral ligament. You don't find this ligament in usual anatomy book, but you can Google that. You can Google spiral glenohumeral ligament, then you see the picture of this ligament. So I think this is quite interesting ligament. You should know this ligament. So if you know this, maybe you can apply for your clinical experience. Maybe you can apply for rehab program. Maybe you can apply for training. I don't know. knowing anatomy is always good, right? In this video, I explain ligaments around thorax, ribcage, and shoulder. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.